Africa's most prolific human killer doesn't hunt on the open plains. In fact, it doesn't hunt for food at all. It's vegetarian. It's the wild card in the pack of Africa's deadliest.
People tend to look at animals like that as, you know, inoffensive, non-aggressive. The fact of the matter is that hippo is responsible for more deaths, more injuries in Africa than all the other animals combined.
An adult hippo grows up to 16 feet long, 5 feet tall, and weighs up to 9,000 pounds. Although it's a huge animal, much of it remains hidden from view. Only its eyes, ears, and nostrils are exposed. When partially submerged, it's easy to believe they are harmless.
This is an incredibly powerful animal, and it's very misleading because in looking at it, so heavy, so apparently almost obese, this animal is incredibly rapid. It can run like it's made out of styrofoam.
Hippos live in groups, or pods, of 10 to 30 animals. A dominant bull defends the pod's territory, which unfortunately for tourists, is invisible to the untrained eye. If something breaches its borders, a hippo starts with a warning. Not everybody takes the cue.
They'll open their mouths. People think, oh, they're yawning, they're tired. It's not that at all. That's a threat.
If the warning is ignored, the male moves in. Surprisingly, hippos can't swim, and they can't float either. But they can walk underwater at around 5 miles per hour. And they can stay submerged for 30 minutes. Like a silent killer submarine, it hones in on its target. Trapped in the hippo's mouth, the victim is impaled on the gigantic tusks. Its bite force is extreme.
The hippo is going to make the decision whether you live or die. I don't think there's anything you can do to avoid it.